Nancy Rotary.
Good morning.
All right, let's start off invocation. Ken, that would be Danny.
Bow our heads. Okay, just a little white space in here. Some tornado victims are showing us how we are able to love one another. Random acts of kindness are being performed by the suffering and volunteers alike. We are thankful for so many creative people that are willing to stick their necks out and help a neighbor. Let us remember why we are really gathering on Thursday mornings. We are grateful to be able to make a difference for so many others less fortunate. Help us continue to do our best, whether we're fundraising or doing the physical things we do. Thanks for this great food, and please help us to keep the four-way test in front of mind. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand for the flag. Of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Is it true? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned?
Thank you, Danny. Chris Jackson.
Chris is right here. You know what you're doing, Chris?
Nope.
So tell us who our guests are today. And you don't need to mention the speakers. We'll get those.
Okay.
He's good. Let him go.
Okay, so today we have Aaron Daniel, who's a guest of Charles Langdon.
Hey, Charles.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, there you are.
I'm Aaron. Here's Aaron.
Buster
and his guest, Lynn Thompson.
I'll introduce her.
Yeah, she's one of the bigger
ones. You got a visiting Rotarian.
Oh, yes, we have a visiting Rotarian, Carl Ashby of the Greensboro.
Hey, Carl.
Outstanding job, Chris.
First week.
Better one. Miss Dale, can you give us an update? A birthday update? Yeah. Anniversary?
Well, we don't have any birthdays. But we have one member anniversary. Chip Person on the 15th will be celebrating 15 years of Gate City Rotary. We have three wedding anniversaries. Becky and Tom Phoenix will be celebrating on May 12th their 29th anniversary. Carrie and Guy Rubando on the 15th of May will be celebrating their 20th anniversary. Kelly and Kelly Harrell on the 16th of May will be celebrating their 27th anniversary.
Any announcements?
Real quick. I've had this blue sweatshirt in the back of my truck for about a month now. If anybody lost their lift and can't carry, let me know. If anybody did and anybody wants a size large L.L. Bean sweatshirt, let me know.
That's mine.
Oh, I
know. It wasn't until you said large. Yeah. Yeah. All right. I do want to make a quick announcement about Rob Midget's father. His service will be... today at 2 o'clock at White Stone Retirement. I think Jonathan and somebody else are going to go to that. Any other announcements? No, we got one. All right. Well, meeting in the room. Any announcements? You got anything you want to say before? Sorry, you're done. You're just... If you haven't said anything, it's nothing to be said.
I'm cooked, I'll tell you that. So we have passed out sponsorship package. I believe most people have theirs. There's still a couple to go. We need some sign-ups for folks to work at the front door. I'm passing around a sign-up sheet. Those of you that have not done this before, go back this way. Goes across the line.
Good luck.
Back here to the front. G Gigi, your responsibility is to bring the sheet back to me, okay?
Okay.
So the table gets it.
I will.
We'll be a little bit flexible in here, but we need some folks to work the sign up, you know, sign in, so people can check in.
What time is it starting? Do we have these people, is it on there?
It's on here, yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. Gates are supposed to open at 7, but we'll need to be there setting up before that. James and I'll be there about 6, and we need some folks signed up to help check in about 6:30, I believe, okay? Let's see, the event, if you have a red badge, the event is black tie. You're not laughing. No, it's very casual, we're going to have a great time. At this point, the deal is, as I said, just come, have a great time. If you have anybody that's a potential sponsor for next year, please bring them. The mood lighting and the at any rate, yeah, if you've got a potential sponsor, bring them tonight. I'll give them a ticket and get them in so they can kind of see what it's all about. Okay? Here goes the sign-up sheet. Good luck. And if you want to, you can add your name. If there's not a number left, you're certainly welcome to come and help. Believe me, we'll use the help. Okay?
Oh, and we're starting working on next year.
I was gonna say, no. Is that it, Walt?
That's it for me.
All right. Anybody have any extra spot? I had mentioned to Bobby, I think, that we're gonna bring some passes. I was gonna invite the Kaiser, Jed O'Donnell, the principal, to the event. I wanted to hook him up. Does anybody have two that they're not gonna use? Two sponsor badges. I want to give them a treat.
Why don't you borrow one?
I've already bought one. Huh?
I do have some.
Got to be here every week.
I mentioned an email yesterday.
Get it, Mike.
Yeah, they'll only let 200 people on the VIP deck at a time. We sold a lot more than that in sponsorships. So, as I said last night, it's a taco bar. And there's a private bar up there and private restrooms. Doesn't mean it's a free bar, okay? That's very different. All right, Rob, you cannot get all that you want to do. At any rate,
family home back.
Yeah, exactly. If you're not going to use your armbands or whatever, please turn them in back to me. Let me know. I will not redistribute them, but be discreet as far as going up there. If you go up to the VIP deck, don't go up there and lounge around for 3 hours. You know, go up there, get your food, come back down, tell everybody, hey, you should have been a sponsor. Let's see.
Well, don't worry about those dreams that you've been having this week. Nobody will show up here. I promise people.
Yes.
Those are the ones I have.
Okay.
Well, I still need a couple of those little adapters that go from a terms of
swipe cards.
Yeah, to a hard swipe card, a headphone jacket. It's a little wire that comes to your iPhone.
Anybody? Does anybody have one of those? I know we heard a couple of people.
How do you have that one? With a 7-8 or 10.
Does anybody have one of those?
What?
Justice, I know you got one. You don't have one of those large ones?
That's not what he's asking for. He's asking for the lighting.
Oh, the adapter for it. Okay.
A little cord.
I got
the things. I need a little cord.
I apologize.
A little dollar.
Yeah. All right. Any other announcements? Voter reviewed here. You know I'm going to get the presidents and then past presidents since they don't ever show up. And I was hoping you would because this might be one you've done before. We got one on the same website. So just pretend like you did.
Past
president and the 10th person team here. All right, the question is name it and it's your option. I know. That's why you did it. Name a recreational activity traditionally done in hot weather. Then would you like pass or play? There are 5 answers on the board. Name a recreational activity traditionally done in hot weather. Since we got a little hot weather, I thought that'd be appropriate.
All right, we'll play.
All right, starts off then.
Swimming.
Number one answer, ding, ding, ding.
Baseball.
Number two answer, ding, ding, ding.
Golf.
Yeah. Good guess, though. And now it's getting tricky, isn't it? The top two.
What is the
I'm going to give it to you because I feel sorry that you have 2 inches. Bodie. Bodie.
That was my hiking.
And Matthew stole my, I'm looking at my phone, so. Number three. All right, guys. Hot weather, y'all like that? Volleyball and surfing.
Volleyball.
You got to make a difference, guys. Come on. We're fortunate today to have We're fortunate today to have two of our grant recipients speaking. Our first is going to be Cheryl Villers, who y'all know is Tony's wife. Tony couldn't be here today, obviously, because of kids, but obviously he was here after all, having given some technical help. Cheryl is responsible for or is involved with GoFar, and all of my kids have been a part of GoFar. So it's a special program. I think you have some photos and things.
What about Happy Dog?
We don't need Happy Dog today. I'm just kidding. But we're going to have Happy Dog.
We've only had a year.
I can't figure that 8 months in.
We want to do Happy Dog.
Yes,
we
have Happy Dog.
Let me just tell y'all a little tip here I've discovered today. If you sit at this table, you never have to play Rotary Theater.
Just a little thing said this morning.
You're just in the mood not to play.
But everybody loves to play, so that's why.
Yeah, everybody loves to play.
First up, I'm a sponsor partly because of my kids' talent. This is a ceramic piece made by my son Paul. He's graduating from Bishop McGinnis in a week, and that guy, they made a class from Honors Pottery 5, and he can do some great things. So we have a workshop in the back, and I'm just grateful. All the other boys that have gone through high school did the same thing, but he's at an advanced level, so if anybody needs a bonsai pot or some plates or something, you may call.
So this afternoon, about 2:50, my daughter has her final senior project. She has to defend a thesis. And so I'm looking forward to not hearing, Dad, you got 18 minutes that I can go over
there? Dang. My daughter, Mary Claire, who works for a pediatric heart transplant doctor at MUSC in Charleston, was just named Nurse of the Year. So.
He allowed Trotter Brothers to install new carpet in his reception area. Thank you. That looks great.
Is it waterproof?
Yeah.
All right, it's my understanding that in my absence last week, Jeff Tillman was talking some smack about Grimsley beating the Northwest in a meaningless season game after while we were resting girls and after we clinched the conference championship. I did want to point out that while we were enjoying our first round bye last night, being the second seed in the West, Grimsley lost to Southman. Good job on the early exit. You want to see some real soccer come out?
That outside. Really happened, Al? Ouch.
True story. When Walt was talking about the tuxedos at the door, brought back an old memory from 1987. I've been invited to an art show over in Winston-Salem, along with about 500 other people, and my buddy in Greensboro asked me to go. He said, black guy. So we got over there, and I'm not lying to you. There were two guys in black ties, him and me, and there were 498 people that looked like y'all.
You were a waiter.
Oh, my goodness. Well, the first thing someone says to me is, we need some more ice.
Did you get it for them?
No. I said, we do.
Wilder, my youngest, had a big adventure a week and a half ago. He went to the southern tip of Patagonia, which is in Tierra del Fuego, right down just less than 100 miles from the from Antarctica, and went hiking as they were closing the park down, and he got an extended bus ride out. They had to extend one day to get out of there. All the ferries were closed up, and they got to the next town that they could fly from, and all the flights were canceled. And so they had, he and six or eight other students worked some deal with LATAM Airways, and they got out of there. But he was asked to speak at the University of Concepcion to address 70 foreign students that are in school there and all the faculty teaching them. And the funny thing is after his harrowing deal, he got back in time for the one class. Teacher said, I'm going to give you F if you don't show up for this class one more time. He made that class. They called him three times. He's supposed to speak at 2:00. They called him three times that morning to be sure he was coming by to say hi. Anyway, he spoke and all was well.
Well, Grandpappy Lewis told me, he said, one day you're going to wake up and you're going to realize you're not a big fish in a little pond. He said, you're not even a little fish in a big pond. You're going to find out that you're a little fish in a big fish.
Put it on there. Thanks, Buck. Cheryl was trying to be considerate of Jonathan because her thing was triggered and she exited out of the program. So if you could, we could have your speaker. Our other grant recipient.
Well, I want to introduce you today my good friend Lynn Thompson. And Lynn and I have known each other for 40 years. I met her when I was just out of college and realized there were no women in the warehousing business. So I was hanging out at UNCG after I graduated. And Lynn actually introduced me to Lisa. So we were hanging out together and this cute girl comes through. Lisa, come over and meet my friend Buster. So anyway, I owe Lynn a lot. But Lynn has, for years, she's been involved with the refugee immigrant community. And she's part of an organization called New Arrivals Institute, which as these people come over, many of them don't speak the language, but they're all seeking a better life and safety and opportunity for their families. They go through a lot and they get here and they don't understand many things about what our society, how we function. So Lynn's organization helps them with a lot of things, just becoming acclimated. They teach language classes, they help them with job opportunities. They have this great little preschool that Lisa volunteers in. And so I'm gonna let her talk about a little bit about New Arrivals Institute, and the grant was for this project called Growing Peace, I'm sorry. and it's this wonderful landscaping project that they're doing that's gonna really add to this whole preschool and the whole community, really, as far as changing the landscape of that place where they meet. So anyway, I'll let you.
Okay. So first I want to say thank you so much for the grant, for the project that we're doing, Growing Peace. The whole name is Growing Peace Community and Children's Outdoor Learning Place. So we just call it Growing Peace. But and also, let me just say, I could talk to you for like 30 minutes about this, but I know I don't have that long, so I'm depending on Buster to give me a little, okay, that's enough of it. So, thank you again. We're really, really excited about this project. So, New Arrivals Institute, our mission is helping refugees and immigrants reach self-sufficiency through education. So, everything that we do has to do with educating people. We don't hand out any money. We just have classes. We do all kinds of things, beginning with teaching them English, because you cannot be self-sufficient without knowing English in this country and without having a job. So those are what we consider to be the two most important things. But we have a lot of other things that help them, such as congregational nursing on site 2 days a week, the preschool to help people. The preschool is there only for people learning English. So it's not a drop-off program. They're coming to learn English, and they can bring their preschool children. Actually, because years ago, we were part of Lutheran Family Services, and the Lutheran staff realized that the mothers were not coming to learn English, so they asked the church, would you host this child's class in English class? So preschool, we have a refugee school impact, so we're helping families and children in school. The goal of that program is to keep them to graduate. I have to look at my list, there's so many things, sometimes I forget all of them. We have case management, vocational skills training, lots of other things. So the project, as you can imagine, the money is sparse from the government to help refugees and immigrants, very sparse. And so the money that we receive for these preschoolers is just basically one teacher. So I've been trying to improve the program for years and years, and there's just no money to improve it. Because we're not licensed, because the children are only there for 3 hours. You don't have to be licensed. The parents are there. We don't have to be licensed. So we don't have a way to raise money. And it finally dawned on me that maybe from my exposure to a lot of other good things going on in Guilford County for young children, that a great way to improve the program, maybe the best possible way, would be to improve the outdoor learning environment. Maybe you are aware that the more money that you put into preschool education, the less money that you end up spending on welfare. Did you guys know that? For the more money before the age of 5, the less money after the age of 18 from the government. So if you do an outdoor learning environment, the other thing is outdoor learning is crucial for children. If they're ready for kindergarten, they're going to be ready to be successful in school. So I teamed up with a woman from UNCG, Dr. Linda Hespinus. She educated our group, the church. Oh, I forgot to say, we're located at Peace United Church of Christ. So you probably know that's the corner of basically Wendover and Market Street. This big church, we rent space from them, the whole top floor. There was this sort of decrepit playground, and I always wanted to improve it. Fast forward to this point of realizing that this idea of an outdoor learning environment would be a great idea. So we started talking about it and applying for grants, and I've got these brochures if you want to look at it later. But three more minutes. Okay. So the idea is, instead of fixed equipment, you have a lot of moving parts. And we got a grant to put in from the Community Foundation, to put in a pathway for them to ride around. And we got another grant from Ecolab for the fence. We will be putting in sandboxes, mud kitchens, a lot of edible plants for them to interact with, eat, plant, enjoy, other all kinds of other things for the space. And your donation is going to help continue make that possible. So, any question? Do you have any questions? Okay. Thank you.
Children. They're all boys, 12, almost 10, 7, and 3. So that's where Tony is right now, trying to get everybody to school. But like many of you are, I heard that you are very proud of your children doing the dollar thing. That was really cool. Well, I am proud to be called not only mom or wife, but also coach through the GoFar program. Go Farm is Go Out for a Run, and it is a program across schools. It's a curriculum that was developed by a PA named Robin Lindsay, and she developed this turnkey curriculum for schools and YMCAs to be able to educate children and young adults on health, fitness, wellness, and therefore training for a 5K. It started in High Point in 2003, and Robin Lindsay started noticing a pattern in her patients where the young adults were increasing in weight. They were starting to have some of the illnesses that older adults usually have. And so she decided, she had a passion for running, so she decided to develop this program. And then, and so in the meantime, it started, or in the beginning, it started out with 16 kids in High Point, and now it's over 8,000 in Greensboro. And it's also national. So this first video is a little introduction. About how exciting the program is. Reaching out to other schools and asking them, okay, you know, where'd you begin? What worked for you? What didn't work for you? Because what did not work for General Green in the beginning is that it all rested on the shoulders of one volunteer. And she then, her kids aged out and then the program died. So my goal was to get enough volunteers from the beginning, before we even started, to start small and build up to a bigger program. And to, you know, kind of spread the responsibilities, you know, throughout. Have, you know, I know, or what I found is that, you know, if you ask somebody to volunteer, they'll be like, oh, okay. But if you say, hey, can you keep an eye on these 10 kids? They're like, sure. You know, if you give them a responsibility or a task, they're great. You know, they'll say yes. So first year was 2017, and we started out with 40 kids and 8 volunteers. The 8 volunteers' children automatically made GoFar. Well, we drummed up so much excitement for the program, we ended up having a wait list of 30 children. And it was kind of sad to say no, you know, it was a tough position to be in since it was the first after school program for the kids. The general grade wanted the program to be K through 5, which also kind of was a little bit of a challenge because the kindergartners through second grade need a little bit more help and supervision, but we didn't know that. I mean, because I'm a parent, I'm not a teacher, you know. I'm like, sure, you know, you can do anything. And what I found out is that they could. You know, they really could. Some of my fastest runners were the kindergartners in first grade. So the program is written for third through fifth, but general grade showed them that we could do it. So fast forward to second year, I took feedback from the first year volunteers, and they said, man, we could use more help, okay? Well, you know, this is all new to General Green, but if you ask other schools, they would be thankful for 8 volunteers. Two of them are staff members, are teachers, and I didn't want to burn them out. So I said, okay, I'll find more volunteers, and we want to grow. We don't want to say no. So I had several peer meetings about, this is our program, this is how exciting it is, and this is what you can get from it, and found 35 volunteers. And so we doubled our program, but tripled our volunteers. And I can say that this year was amazing. It really was. I was able to see, you know, not only kids transform, but parents with their kids. And they were taking what they learned in GoFar and taking it home and into their communities. You know, I belong to an organization called FIA, Females in Action, and I know you guys know about F3 and probably FIA. But this is, I mean, it's almost like the junior step to that. We had a lot of snow days and a lot of rain days, and the weather was not perfect, and General Green does not have a gym. So we had to be very creative. We were doing boot camp style workouts in the halls, in the media center, in some of the classrooms. You know, we had to change it up a lot. We were running sprints. Even though the weather was bad, I mean, we didn't cancel school. I mean, we didn't cancel a workout. So the children completed 10 weeks with 2 workouts per week. And with the 35 volunteers, we rotated so that the 1 hour that they dedicated a week was actually that 1 hour. You know, I belong to other organizations where they joke, it's only 1 hour a week. But then there's all this, you know, all this work that goes on in the background. So, it was a really successful program, and what I envision for the future is that we can offer scholarships to some of the children and some of the volunteers, since they are donating their time and energy for the kids. And also, you know, there's an annual fee that we need to, you know, kind of like a charter for the GoFar program. So I think this will be, this will be wonderful to us. It's such a gift to be able to have money to, you know, get awards and certificates, you know, for program participants, and thank yous for the volunteers, so hopefully they'll come back next year. So thank you again, Rotary, for giving us the grant. I have a little video, if I can pull it up, of what this season looked like. And I titled it Rotary Short. Because it was a lot longer. But just like, you know, just like your other funders are here, I mean, we're excited.
You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can lead the world. But you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be a hero. You could get the gold. Breaking over with the sleep on the hill could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. Never go alone if you never even try. Do it for your country. Do it for your name. Be champions.